Welcome to 10 years of One Direction. It is the 23rd. It is 6:58 in the morning. I haven't slept since my last video. I thought I'd just update through the day so I wouldn't be so stressed later on. So all that's happened since I left last, I'm going to give you a little rundown of what happened. I am editing the video where I talk about what happened, but I don't know how much I want to actually leave in of it, because it's kind of boring, but I kind of want to leave it in so I can, like, look back on it in, like, 5 more years and be like, remember that? Clownery? There's a new Instagram account that's been posting unseen photos of the boys, but we kind of, like, found out that they weren't that unseen. Anyway, we don't know if it's actually official or not. Kind of a mystery. Then the One Direction Japan official Twitter, Grace and I were like laughing about how it's kind of like annoying because every time they tweet we thought it was One Direction and we were just like joking about it, and then they deactivated their account, which was kind of like, everyone was like freaking out that that meant One Direction might deactivate tomorrow. I say hell to a no. Other than that, I'm pretty sure we've just had some like little small freakouts in the fandoms about the vertical videos on Spotify were all added to Spotify of like all the albums. So there's vertical videos now you can watch. And on the Olivia song on Spotify, if you swipe up twice, it has the Olivia storyline, which is really cute. And we had the iHeart live stream countdown to unseen moments of One Direction, and like literally the whole freaking fandom stayed up just to watch it, and the countdown to the thing was 2 minutes, and the video of its like actually unseen things that weren't actually unseen was like 1:30, so the countdown was longer than the video itself, and we stayed up waiting this whole time for things we've already seen. But like, beggars can't be choosers. We all clowned. Big clown. And Zayn's sister, it was Safa, she posted about One Direction on her Instagram story, which was very cute. Other than that, I think Liam and Niall are going on the radio at 8 in an hour. It's just gone 7:01. You can't really see that. It's just gone 7:01. Just waiting to see what else happens, but happy 1D day. My friends are going to a concert right now. Exciting! I have to take my makeup off and reapply it and then go have a photo shoot. Gang gang, I will update when something drastic happens. The One Direction website crashed at 12 in the morning, like on the dot. And nobody could get into it, and everyone was freaking out and hella stressed, but literally nothing happened. So, big clowns, we are the clowns. We are the clowns. What else can we say? It's already been known. Okay, it is 10:15 a.m. now. I have just gotten up again. I took my makeup off about 6, and then I lay down and listened to some One Direction and was waiting for Liam to go on the radio. He went on the radio at about 8:20. And then all shit went loose. Like that. Not only did Liam go on the radio, but Niall also went on the radio at the exact same time. And apparently Harry went on Kiss at the same time as well. I didn't see that, but apparently it happened, and we crashed all the sites. So that's fun. Everyone was like freaking out. Liam gave us some, that's gonna fall off again. Liam gave us some blessed quotes. I will find some and read them out. Liam said, being in the band felt safe. We all love a bit of Tomo. And he's all for a One Direction reunion. And then Niall just talked about like the band and stuff. And then both websites crashed and we have no clue what they said. So, and when the boys were on the radio, it was really cute because they literally both went on the exact same time. So none of the stands could like do anything because you're either listening to Liam's or Niall's. I don't know, Harry just kind of came in there at the end, but like, you couldn't really choose. So Niall's and Liam's. So Niall's was trending and then Liam's was trending at the same time. And it got trending because all the people in Niall's stream were saying, we'll record Niall's stream for the Liam's so they can stay on Liam's stream. And then vice versa with Liam's stream. And it's really cute. We stand our fandom coming together. That happened. Also, people are starting to post. Liam posted about the Don't Fall. Don't fall, I believe in you. It's gonna fall. Liam posted and he said, what a journey. I had no idea we were in for when I sent this text to my dad 10 years ago at this exact time the band was formed. Thanks to everyone that supported us over the years, and thanks to the boys for sharing this with me. Hashtag 10 years of One Direction. With this photo that he sent to his dad saying, I'm in a boy band! And then this photo of the boys. Cry. And then other people shared about it, like Louise Teasdale posted some photos of the boys and things that she's done, like styling wise on them. And then Sandy posted, I think John posted, just some. Everyone's posting slowly. Justin, breaking One Direction news. Wake up, Louis is trending number 9 worldwide. Can you see that? Louis, wake up. It's Louis, wake up. I'm dyslexic. So I'm going to put some makeup on, drink tea, and then think about taking photos. My friends just called me from their One Direction concert. I might insert a little clip. They're so cute. I'm so glad they're having such a good time. I was jamming with them for a few songs. Also, the people behind them were like vibing with me because I was on FaceTime and I was like, hey people, I'm here. Okay, makeup. Don't really have anything to update on. Oh, my curls look nice. Apart from, I look really cute right now. So, cute things. I got One Direction tattoos on my ankles. Can you see that? X marks the spot. And this one on this side. I can't really show you without like flashing. There is a video dropping in like an hour, 2 hours on the One Direction account. So stay tuned for that.
It's Clown City over here, guys. So much has happened. Look, Grace is here. Oh yeah, the freaking website. Don't even get me started on the website. Look at Grace's old friend. Hey Grace, this is, look, we are making content, queens. Don't even get me started on the website because I tried to get into that website for literally 2 hours. I still can't get into it. Literal hard times. Gonna make you wanna, why you even try? It literally just won't load, but apparently there's, like, all this stuff on the website. They've, like, revamped the website. And it just hates me. Yeah. So, I can't get on the website. But I don't think a lot of people can either. What else has happened? We're all clowning. I think the, like, most relevant thing that's happened recently is, the like video came out at 4 p.m. and honestly we just cry.
We're so dumb.
I liked it. I mean, it was better than the iHeart one.
Yeah.
Anything's better than the iHeart one.
It's just not what I was like.
Grace is just emo because she's up late and she's gonna die. She's gonna lose her marbles. It was really cute. Louis said, what did he say?
Hey, Harry.
Hey, Harry.
And I cried because that photo.
Louis followed Harry.
Yeah, Louis.
On Instagram.
Oh, we're gonna fucking just like yeet ourselves. That photo, that like clip of Louis panning over to Harry and saying, hey, Harry. Louis fucking videoed that himself on his fucking phone. And he literally, that is like the photo. There's a photo of that came out literally when it was like Yeah, that's like my favorite photo of them because they're so domestic and they're like not being like overly touchy because cameras are on and around them. They're just like naturally like that and I fucking sob. And it's just like blue greening season is upon us. The bandana is here. I'm still waiting. Okay, we are waiting for Zayn Malik to tweet. I mean, his sister said something about it, so he has to do something. He just is like not an option at this point. We are still waiting for the. I feel like the Infinity music video is gonna come out. I feel like it just has to. I feel like if it's not, I feel like if the Infinity music video doesn't come out either tonight or tomorrow, it's never gonna come out. Period.
Yeah. Also because that thing that there's that cryptic shit that I've been talking
about. So do you want to explain that? Or do you want me to explain it?
Okay. I'll go find the thing. So basically, they've been talking about like on the website and stuff, like they've been talking about like secret messages and all their personal tweets that they like tweeted before about the anniversary. They normally like wrote except a few words in capital letters, such as like when they'd like just like tweet, but they just put like random words in capital letters. Like it was us for Niall tomorrow from the One Direction account and all from Louis. Hidden message ?
I just cry. But then also I random capitalize because like my aesthetic. Honestly, just like we're blue greening. We're blue greening in the One Direction fandom, not even in the Larry fandom. We're just like, give us something. We're thirsty! Quench our thirst. Honey, I've been up for like 48 hours, I feel you.
It's been too long.
Too long, 2 days. Okay. Say goodbye to our YouTube. I will update later. Vlog, we're back. I thought of something else. An interview came out yesterday with the boys, and it was from 2011, and apparently it was unseen. My Twitter timeline had never seen it before, and I don't think I'd seen it before, and it was like, I'll send it to you. You tell me if you've seen it.
Okay.
Because we were all like, da 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 da, and then we were like, oh wait, no, this is legit.
Talking about that.
Came out yesterday, very interesting. So, that happened. The 10-year anniversary of One Direction. What a fucking whirlpool. Hence the dizzy filter, because I haven't slept in 3 days. I'm going to give you a little rundown of what happened. Just very brief. Okay, so, really quick. It started off with this freaking account that just came out of nowhere. I think it started posting things a week ago. And yesterday morning, I remember looking at it and seeing that it had 20,000 followers. And then as of right now, I think it has 100,000+ followers. And they're tweeting about One Direction. Well, not tweeting, Instagramming about One Direction. So that's the first bit of fuckery. First bit of fuckery today, Liam and Niall both went on the radio, both went on two different radio stations at the same time. Okay, like, I don't know who the hell thought it was a good idea, but they did it, and we crashed both radio sites so nobody could get access to anything that was happening. All the people on Niall's stream was screen recording it and sending it to the people on Liam's stream, and all the people on Liam's stream were screen recording it and sending it to the people on Niall's stream, but then it all freaking crashed. So Niall's and Liam's was trending worldwide. Then after that, there was a whole palaver as well while all that was going on, that apparently Harry was doing a radio interview with Kiss, but he wasn't. I don't know where that came from. Clownery!
This morning, really early, it was at 5, everyone stayed up the night before not to miss the premiere of the One Direction Unseen Tour video from iHeartRadio. And we were clowned because, one, the whole video was literally like a minute and 40 seconds long, if that. And the like premiere time where it counts down was 2 minutes long, and it was literally longer than the whole video. And then on top of that, it wasn't even unreleased like things. I think One Direction don't really fathom that, like, they don't really have unreleased things unless like it's like in a closed room where there's like no fucking curtains or anything. Because even like unreleased things we've seen. This is the fandom that hacked into the Auckland airport security cameras just to watch the boys do nothing for like 2 hours. So that happened. Everyone was real mad. iHeartRadio is over party was trending. I didn't get on that train because cancel culture really isn't my thing, but that happened. And then after that, my friends Faith and Grace were at a One Direction streaming party for the 10-year anniversary in New Zealand because they don't have corona at the moment because they wear masks. They FaceTimed me and jumped around a bit. Thriving. I can insert some of that footage here. Enjoy this clip of me and my friends vibing.
My two best friends just fucking FaceTimed me from this One Direction show they're at in New Zealand. They're at a One Direction listening party right now. I cried.
I had a little photo shoot today. I posted some photos. They'll be on my Instagram if you want to go see them. If not, you don't have to. But I will put in the footage of me setting it up because, I don't know, I filmed it and why wouldn't I put it in? And then we will cut back to what happened after that. Lately I found myself thinking, been dreaming about you a lot. And up in my head I'm your boyfriend, but that's one thing you've already got. So after that, me speed putting up the freaking One Direction 10-year thing, after that, just a whole lot of head arsery happened. One Direction's website went live again, and apparently they changed things on it, but nobody could get into the website. Literally no one. They have like 6 different error pages. Where it would be like, error, like, you've crashed the site or something. And literally, like, nobody was getting on it. People were getting onto, like, the loading page, but it was just loading and loading and loading and loading. I think a handful of people did get on, and apparently it was pretty cool because you could, like, make your own mixtape and stuff. I don't know how that worked, but I'm pretty jealous that I was not part of it. Okay, so the website. The head arsery of us trying to get onto the website and then us not being able to get onto the website. We cry. Everyone tweeted. Well, maybe not everyone. Zayn. Malik. But what we did get is Liam tweeting at 8 a.m. And then I think it was Niall. It was either Niall made an Instagram post and then Louis made a Twitter post. I have my reaction to Louis, so I will insert that now. Okay, Louis just tweeted and I haven't seen the tweet yet. So this is my reaction to Louis' tweet. Ready? Oh my god, he tweeted twice. Oh my god, he tweeted loads of times. What have I been doing? Oh my god. Feeling pretty much to all of my bandmates.
All in capital letters?
Too many incredible memories to think. But not a day goes by that I don't think about how amazing it was. Niall Horan, Harry Styles, Liam Payne, and Zayn Malik. So proud of you all individually. Miss it every day. Ah! Oh my god. I kind of hope Zayn tweets something. I'm not expecting him to, but. Ah! Anyway, I fucking cry. That was my reaction to retweeting. Breaking news, apparently One Direction has a video that premieres in 3 hours. Let's investigate. Panic stand mode. Oh my god. Oh my god. The reminder has been set. What does this mean? What does this mean? Anyway, back to the photo shoot that I've been taking. Whilst I fucking cry. Harry did an Instagram post, and I will put in Grace reading that for us because she joined me in this headassery of this video, so I will get her to read that out for you in her lovely New Zealand accent that I was not very blessed with. And then we will talk a little bit about those tweets and then move on to the next thing.
Okay, since Louis tweeted, Harry tweeted, friggin', let's read out Grace. Do you want to read out what Harry tweeted?
Okay.
Grace is going to read out what Harry tweeted. I will get the photo up.
Let's go. Okay. @Harry_Styles. I've been struggling to put into words how grateful I am for everything that's happened over the last 10 years. I've seen things and places that I'd only ever dreamt of when I was growing up. I've had the pleasure of meeting and working with some of the most incredible people and gained friendships that I know I will treasure for the rest of my life. None of this would be possible without the support you've given along the way. And for that, I will be forever thankful. I just can't believe it's been 10 years. Thank you to our crew, our team, and to everyone else who helped us along the way. To all the fans, I love you all, and I thank you with all my heart. You did it all, and you changed everything. And finally, to the boys, I love you so much, and I couldn't be prouder of everything we achieved together. Here's the 10. H.
Ah, it's the fact that he says our team and our crew, and then he says the boys. The boys!
Yeah, 10, 10, 10.
Holy crap. So Harry tweeted that. Okay, so Harry, the fact that he used our crew and our team and then referred to not Louis, Liam, Zayn, Niall, he referred to them as the boys, which, like, I just cry. I honestly just big cry. That tweet really, really reminded me of 16-year-old Harry for some reason, and it hit me right in the feels. You cry. Louis' tweet, I think the fact that he, like, tweeted Zayn, he, like, added Zayn, and that was, like, a huge thing, and we were all just like, it's happening! It's happening! And then we clowned again, because Zayn was like, it's not happening. But that seems to, like, not be resolved, but, like, getting better, because at least he's, like, speaking his name. The fact that Louis put, all in capitals, we cry. Liam's tweet about, also, Liam's tweet sparked, like, a whole lot of, like, panic, because he said that he got, he messaged his dad at 8:09 p.m., but the fandom has literally been celebrating on the door of when they got put together at 8:22. It literally says it on my broken watch. 8:22 p.m. 8:22 p.m. Friday, the 23rd of July, 2010. But apparently it's not. So then we were like, oh, okay, it must be the around, like, on the hour of 8. But then Louis replied to a post about Jay,
his mom talking about how she took the first photo of One Direction that, like, ever existed. And she said that she got a call from Louis at 7:30 saying that he'd just been put in a band. So, the whole timeline's fucked. I think we've just, like, collectively agreed to keep the time at 1:22 because I feel like people have that tattooed and now they're just, like, clowning. It's literally been Clown Town. Clown Town. Okay. After the tweets, Niall's just so pure. He's still posting about it. And it's, like, a really funny time in, like, the fandom right now because we've been so full on for 3 days that I feel like everyone's just asleep right now, which I am rushing through this because I'm trying to sleep before something else happens. Anyway, Niall, baby, we don't deserve you. Anyway, next headassery, we got a One Direction live stream. Well, it wasn't really a live stream. It was like another live countdown thing to another unseen, like, tour memory thing. It was really tour memory. It's like of their lives in One Direction. And it was like, there's just been so much happening in, like, the Larry realm in the past 2 days, but I can't even keep up because I'm, like, focused on One Direction. I'm trying to, like, not blue-green, but it's really hard. They showed a clip of Louis and Harry in the underground, I'm guessing somewhere in London or something. And Louis pans over, he must be filming on his phone or something, pans over to Harry and he, like, calls him and it's, I literally cry. That, like, scene is, like, from the same photo, like, the same time as, like, one of my favorite photos of Louis and Harry ever. The one where they're on the tube and, like, somebody's taken a photo of them from, like, a few seats down and Louis got his arm around Harry and they're talking to some, like, elderly people and they just look so soft and domestic and it's not like they're putting it on for anyone else. They're just, like, enjoying each other's company and I miss that. I really, really miss that. We got really good Zayn content from that One Direction vault. I guess I'll call it a vault. Everyone was kind of like, what the fuck? Because I think we all thought it was going to be the Infinity music video. This is my tea on the Infinity music video. I think if it doesn't come out on the 23rd, it's the 23rd now in America. So if it doesn't come out tomorrow, I don't think it'll come out at all. Like, I don't think when they get back together, I don't think they'll drop it because they'll probably want to make new music, make more music videos. So it's sitting on someone's computer and that shit just ain't right. It don't sit well with the fandom. Anyway, we got some really cute moments just to, like, cry over. And I think after that, the fandom was, like, relatively chill. One Direction tweeted about them releasing, like, HD 4K new music videos of, like, What Makes You Beautiful and, like, those kind of things. So I watched that and it's not really that different. And then Peace of the Distance. Louis Tomlinson followed Harry Styles on Instagram. Somebody tweeted that everyone's, like, disappointed about the Infinity music video. So Louis just hopped on and said, we gotta feed them something. So he went and followed Harry. I think he followed Zayn as well. But I thought they were already, like, I definitely thought Louis was already following Harry. I don't know. I feel like we clown about this all the time. Because we're like, oh, Harry followed this person, or Harry unfollowed this person, but he was either already following them or never following them at all. I don't know. Yeah. So that's about it so far, I think. I don't think anything else has happened. We're just out here crying over the boys tweeting, and Niall's still posting. And not even that they're all posting separately. But it's that they're all, like, intermingling with each other, like Harry is posting and then Niall will comment on Harry's thing, or like Liam will comment on Louis, or Louis will comment on Niall's, and then like you got Josh Devine and Sandy and like the whole like fandom. I'm gonna be so, so sad when this all quiets down. Because this is like, this is it until either One Direction gets back together or probably the 15-year anniversary, which is 5 years away. Okay, I'm not gonna get in that headspace right now because we don't need that. I hope you had an amazing, amazing 10-year anniversary. Even though we were all stuck in Clown Town, but hey, it is still the 23rd in America. Same? There's still time for Sam to tweet. I had a dream that Zayn and Gigi had their baby today, and that it was like kind of like a, if you don't tweet about One Direction, you have baby today. And they just have a baby and they call it freaking Direction. They call it, what do they call it? Kevin. Yeah, call it Kevin. Anyway, that's basically it. I have a few more videos on the way. I got One Direction tattoos, so that video is coming. That was the 10-year anniversary of One Direction. For myself, looking back at this video in a few years, I don't think you have ever been this stressed, but like thankful for the stress. Because although it was like really stressful trying to get onto the website and all that stuff, I was kind of just like breathing it in, taking it in, because it's not going to be like that in a few days. It's just going to be back to the freaking Harry's fighting with the Louis and the Louis fighting with the Harry's and people not liking Liam. And this is like the first time that I've seen, I think I've seen two negative tweets on my timeline in the past 3 days. That is the power of the One Direction fandom. Yeah. So thank you for spending your Monday day watching me friggin' run around and cry in Clown Town. I hope that you have a good day. And for both of our sakes, I hope that Zayn tweets. For Zayn's sake, I hope Zayn tweets. But I'm not going to hold it against him because he is a grown man, and the reasons why he left One Direction are very, very valid. And if he doesn't want to associate himself with them, he doesn't. I can just thrive off his sisters and his mom having little streaming parties. Okay, I am signing off. I'm gonna go sleep. Probably not gonna sleep. I'm probably gonna freak out about Zayn tweeting and then he's not gonna tweet. I'm stuck in Clown Town. Let's see if in the next video I can claw my way out. I have been Andrada and you have been, I don't know, there. See you in the next one. I thought we were done with this, but no. Quickly, we're still in Clown Town. One Direction website went up last night again. They re-put it up. And I just finished looking through it. And it's made me feel some type of way. I think the Twitter timeline was so intense for the last 3 days that now it's like stopped. Everyone's like sleeping because nobody slept. It's like the worst post-concert depression, and it wasn't even a concert, but like, it's like we got a glimpse back in 2012 only to have it ripped away from us a day later. The website's really sad, but really like, it's like a bittersweet feeling, with like a lot of sad mixed in there. There's an envelope on the last page under Harry talking about 5 years in the band, and nobody could open it, so maybe that's our fucking ticket out of Clown Town. I don't know. Anyway,
Sorry, this video is really long. I thought I'd just leave it in because I like watching videos back, and I'll probably watch it back in a few years and think, wow, things really do hit that hard, hey? Anyway, I'm going now.